Hello everyone, my name is AZZATRU, how are you? And welcome to another Star Wars Battlefront 2 news update video of mine. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you some new details on the ARC Troopers, plus why we didn't get Clone Commandos, why we should be expecting a roadmap update this month, and a few other things. Because when I posted the ARC Trooper video yesterday, a few hours after that, we got some new details, like the health point cost and a few other things. So let's just get straight into this news update. So we'll kick things off with the battle point cost. This was a question a lot of you guys have been asking. Basically, CJ, the designer of them, on Twitter stated that they're still being tweaked, so there is no final number yet, but they won't be drastically different from the existing reinforcements in the game, which is what we'd expect anyway. As for health points, Jay confirmed on the forums that pending final balancing, it's currently at 350 health. And some people were asking, is it still going to be locked to the new game mode, these reinforcements and Galactic Assault? Why aren't they going to be available on Strike and Blast? Well, Jay confirmed on Reddit last night that the team have expanded these new reinforcements to all of the relevant game modes that have reinforcements, which is great to hear. So it means you're not just going to have to play Galactic Assault or the brand new game mode this month to get these new reinforcements. Now, a lot of you have been asking, why didn't they pick Clone Commandos? Are they just lazy? Well, this is what Jay said on Discord. For reinforcements, the Commando is a very, very good one. Its counterpart would probably be something like Droidicas, and adding a reinforcement that don't balance each other wouldn't really add a good gameplay experience. Beyond that, work timelines are the biggest reason. The ARC Trooper was faster to make and checked a ton of boxes, such as fun, balance, unique abilities, and stuff like that. For the Commando, we'd probably have to do a lot more legwork since they're barely explored in canon and not worth delaying reinforcements just for that, because if you think about it, the amount of approvals they have to go through and just to get these community transmissions out, it's a hell of a task, and it seems like they probably didn't want to risk delaying the reinforcements for a couple of months or something like that just because of the canon with Lucasfilm and stuff like that. And Jay also mentioned that they also did a specific brand new B2 droid instead of the BX Commando droid, but they're glad that the team decided not to do that and focused to do more work on the Commando droid. And me too. I think if there was going to be a new B2, I would be so underwhelmed. To have three different B2 battle droids as reinforcements, come on, really? That would be so disappointing. But we are going to be getting a Commando droid, so hats off to them for actually sticking to it and putting in the effort to make a brand new droid. Now, a lot of you in the previous video's comment section were saying, hold on a second, did you just say the game mode community transmission is coming next, not the lightsaber one, which should have been the first one of these four community transmissions? Yes, that's correct. They've decided to change it around, probably because people can't wait for the new game mode, and basically the new game mode information is going to be coming before the lightsaber changes. So the next community transmission, which will be coming next week, there'll be two next week, will be starting with the game mode. So probably like a Tuesday, like this week, hopefully we'll get the new game mode announcement and the new information on that, and then a few days later we'll get the lightsaber combat one, and then probably on the Monday, the day before the update, we'll get the patch notes and final overview community transmission, because that lines up with all the previous patches. And last but certainly not least, a lot of you guys have been asking about the roadmap, and basically there will be a roadmap update this month. That's what's to be expected anyway. Jay said that on Discord, so fingers crossed. I mean, Ben did mention a couple of days ago that is the plan if all things keep going as they are, so who knows? Things could change between now and the end of the month, but at this moment in time, it's looking pretty likely. What we will get in that roadmap update, I have not a clue. New heroes, I would personally prefer new weapons and a new planet, if I'm perfectly honest. I'm pretty satisfied with the new heroes that we've been getting over the last few months, but who knows? We'll just have to wait and see. But let me know in the comment section below your thoughts on everything I've discussed in this video. I'm going to be really interested to see your thoughts on the new information about the ARC Troopers and stuff like that, so please do let me know in the comment section down below. Be sure to drop a like if you enjoyed this video, and do subscribe if you have not already to stay up to date with all Battlefront 2 news and information like this, and check out any of the two previous videos on screen if you did miss them, and I shall see you all in my next Star Wars Battlefront 2 video. Goodbye.